Are you ready for a new node? Let's dive in and check it out.
Vellum Weld. Vellum Weld is super useful. It fuses points during simulation. However, outside of simulation, these points are still unfused. This has a wide range of uses, but let's take a look at a basic setup and how we can manipulate things to get what we want. So I'm here in an empty scene and we're going to start with a grid. This grid's a little bit big for what we need. So let's reduce the size to 3 and 1. So we have a nice long, thin grid. We're going to change the rows and columns to 2 and 2. This helps when we remesh that we don't get any artifacts. In our remesh, we're gonna reduce the target size to 0.03. And if we turn on the wireframe, we can see we get some nice dense triangles, which will be great for what we want. Next, we're gonna add in an edge fracture. This node fractures our geometry along the current wireframe. So if I turn on this piece attribute, you can see that it's not cutting through our geometry triangles, but rather it's running along the geometry triangles. This is important to know as it produces different results than if you would use a Boolean, for example, because the Boolean would cut through our triangles. And sometimes that gives some artifacts that we don't necessarily want. What we can do is increase this to something like 125, so we get a lot more cuts and edges. Next, what we'll do is we'll drop down a group node, and we can turn off the preview of this because we don't need to see it anymore. What we want to do now is just group the two edges. So we'll create point groups, we'll disable base group, and we'll just use this bounding box. And we'll do one on this side, and let's label this group edge 01, and we'll duplicate this group and we'll move it across to the other side, and we have edge group 02. The next thing we want to do is drop down a vellum cloth. For now, we'll keep everything at default. We just want to pin those groups that we just created, so edge 1 and edge 2, and they will be permanent. Next, we're going to add in our vellum weld. As you can see, by default, it now goes through and it welds all those pieces that we created with our edge fracture. All those pieces are now welded with this weld node. And so what that's doing is, in the simulation, it'll see these points as one point rather than two and separate pieces of geometry. So next, we're going to drop down a vellum solver, and we'll just jump up to 4 substeps. We'll leave gravity on. And if we hit play now, we'll just have a piece of cloth that falls down. Nothing happens to it. Even though we have all these fractures, like I said, because those points are seen as the same point, nothing will change in this simulation. So let's add a sphere, and we're going to use this as a collider to collide through our cloth. So we can reduce the scale to something like 0.2. And let's change it to a polygon and give it a bunch more subdivisions so that it's nice and smooth. Next, we're going to add a transform node so that we can animate our sphere. We're going to move it down, and then after 30 frames, let's move it up to 0.55. So we get a nice upward movement that's going to push through our cloth. Let's plug this into the third input, which is where we plug in our collision objects. If we hit play right now, we'll see that it still doesn't break because we haven't enabled the breaking threshold. So if we go to the Vellum Weld node and we look at the breaking, we can check this on. The default value of 0.1 is quite low. So when we hit play with a value of 0.1, all the weld points are immediately broken and unwelded. If we increase this value to something like 0.5, this means hold the weld constraint longer and wait for more stress before you break. So what that means is a lot of the weld points will not break in this case, only the ones that have a very high stretch stiffness. You can also scale the breaking threshold by a value. Here I'm using an attribute noise set to break threshold scale. Now the areas that are blue will break a lot more easily. You can get even more control if you use an attribute paint. You can paint the areas you want to be unbreakable. In this case, my values are inverted, so I'll use an attribute remap, which is a really useful node to invert or remap values. Also didn't use a sphere as a collider, but just an upward wind velocity. You can also release the breaking threshold with an attribute, which is really useful. Let's keep our grid with the pinned edges. Then we can create a simple falloff using a mask from geometry. I'm using a sphere in the center of my grid, and then I'm animating the radius so I get a nice outward growth. Inside the Vellum solver, I'm using a geometry wrangle. In the inputs tab, I'm referring to the out falloff null that I created. In the code section, I'm bringing in my mask attribute using a point function. I'm then saying if the mask attribute is bigger than 0.5, unweld my points. I'm also using that same falloff attribute to affect my wind, so once points are released, they'll fly up. You can use different types of falloff to release the welds to get some really fun results. This is obviously not limited to grids. You can use your favorite geometry and set it up as a soft body with struts and do the previous steps we did with the falloff. You can also use this effectively when mixing different vellum constraints together, such as the grains and cloth. You can get some really fun interaction. Vellum Weld is super fun and has a variety of cool uses, so why don't you give it a try, jump in, try it out. It's Houdini time.